people. We are back for some FNM. Some modal modern FNM. Playing Stoneblade. Played the deck last week, played two leagues. Went 3-2 in both. No, 4-1 and 4-1 and 3-2. And then 2-1 in our Chimera event last weekend. Which I oddly enough got Blood Mooned, even though I play like six basics. No, it was five basics. Only made a couple changes. Playing fourth Raven Inspector now. We cut the two Snapcasters and the two Ops, which was the tech that the creator of the deck did. Which I actually kind of like. It gives you more targets for an IMB, which we didn't get to use too much last week. And honestly, I didn't end up using the Snapcaster really at all in my leagues. I flashed it a couple times to just have an attacker. So we will see. Therm Inspector kind of does the same thing, gets you a draw from the Ops, which is what you're looking for, and then it gives you another target for an IMB or the Swords. So overall, deck is pretty sweet. I like it. I'm enjoying it. We'll see what we can do today with it. A little bit of a smaller event today. It should be starting in a minute. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be loading right now. We break the system. Oh, there we go. I mean, it's just pray not to get the buy today. We'll play some magic. Do you, anyone get to open any time spiral yet? And we opened like five boxes. Value seemed pretty good. Even though we didn't hit a lot of the big old border stuff, and the foils we hit were not that great, there was still like a ton of value in the box. But I did get to see a couple old border foils that looked really nice. The Yawgmoth is real, real sick. That old border black, like bubbly tar look is really cool. Then we also opened a Blood Braid, which is pretty nice. Definitely made me think about maybe getting that for my Jund deck. Who are we waiting on? Whose deck list didn't get up? I don't know. Yeah, what's up, Haynes? Was it Burke? Burke, do you miss your deck list? As long as it wasn't me, that's all that matters. It's embarrassing when it's me. I'm only saying that, Burke, because I heard Taylor complaining about something. Yeah, Chris, did you pick up any Time Spiral yet? Do you have plans on picking up foils? Yeah, the box prices are going up. Faces are like Face had them at 250, I believe. Today, like maybe 4 p.m., I noticed that they were at 280, and then we just checked a couple minutes ago and they're at 300. So they've already increased their box price twice. You have OG Thoughtseize though, right? It's like no reason to replace the OG ones. Yeah. I have invocations, so like I have invocations and I have full arts and I have Theros foils. So I have like three choices of like what foils to use, but they're definitely nice. We got a non-foil in today and it is tempting. But I wouldn't mind getting like some foil true names. Foil Abrupt Decays, they look really cool. Yeah, BBE and Decay look sweet. It's just some cards. There's a specific list of old border cards that aren't in the set. Oh, no way. I didn't even realize that they were in Japanese. Right. That's dope. That thing's gonna be worth a fortune. Wow. Yeah, Rue told me that he sold his foil Ponder like almost immediately after they posted it on the website, and he was like, damn it, probably put that too low. Yeah. Was crazy. All right, it looks like whatever happened to melee have pushed our thing back 5 minutes. Yeah, but it's a common, but it's like they're all the same rarity in that slot, right? Wow, complete sets. How many boxes do you have to open to get a complete set? That's insane. Wow. And I was talking to a bunch of other stores who like barely got over 20 boxes. The system is rigged. All these little stores trying to do a thing, can't even get enough boxes to sell sets. Who's buying this stuff too? Like, just throwing money at full sets of foil old border. Yeah, I heard FaZe open like a crap ton of boxes. Yeah, they are like the biggest, so that makes sense. Yeah. But then you also gotta find someone to buy them after that. Yeah, that's fair. I'm still so salty about Goyf. I don't know if I could ever forgive Wizards for that. Like that, yeah, I know. Like, spoilers start next week? Yeah, that's crazy. This whole year, you think like we've been in a whole year of not being able to play actual Magic, and we've had so many sets come out. Like, it feels like we're just like nonstop. Every other week, we're like going into spoiler season for a new product. Yep. Yeah, we got five new commander decks coming out with Strixhaven. Hey, Scarlet, what's up? Yeah, Modern Horizons 2. We were talking about that today. Like, it sounds like the price is going to be insane. Yeah. Thanks, you too. Yeah. It's kind of exciting that they're doing a pre-release, though. So we'll have like pre-release kits or something for Modern Horizons. I hope that we can actually run some kind of event, because that would be hot. Did we get pairings yet? 7:15. Yeah. But like, we're gonna have like full art foil fetches. Have something like super slick for them. And showcase? Oh my god. Here's the real question. How many of the new cards are gonna have to be banned within the first, let's say, 2 months of release? Yeah, they're re reprinting the Zen fetches. Nope. What is happening? Oh, it says loading registrants. We were just talking today about like how many. Oh, I don't know. Are you? I don't even know how to tell. Can you look that up? Is that what the star beside your name is? Aw, yeah. Thank you, Scarlet. Chrome died. We were talking today about how many cards are Modern Horizons are like actually played. It's crazy, like what a big difference it made in the format. Yeah, it doesn't seem like it's loading at all. Let me go ask Tay quick. I love Renin 6. Yeah, Tay said apparently they're having some kind of issues with their server, but they're working on it. I must say, the teamer Delver list that I was like playing around with at Eternal Weekend in 2019 was one of the like m the best decks I've ever played in Legacy. It was so much fun. That card was so powerful. You had Oko and Renin 6. It's just nuts. Force Negation and Force of Will. Like the deck actually felt like it was unbeatable. It's funny because people hadn't really started just jamming Oko and everything at that point. So my three color splash, or I guess it was splash red Saheeli Cat deck, Saheeli Stoneblade deck was only playing one Oko. It's like a couple weeks after that, everyone's like, "Oh man, you just did four Okos and everything. This card's insane." Oh yeah. I got my full art foil Okos. We paid a good price on them. I know, right? It was the worst card in my deck. It is so wild. Like I barely did anything with it. But every time I drew it, I was like, "Eh, this card's fine. It's not gonna do anything here." It's like it's very possible that like it maybe just didn't actually fit in my deck at all, and like it's just because of the way that my deck was built. But there was definitely other decks that you could have built to be better, and to abuse Oko, which we found out shortly after. So, I didn't have enough ways to abuse the turning things into creatures on my side. Like, I didn't have the artifacts to be able to, like, the baubles and, like, random shit to just be like, "Oh, now I have an elk." Yeah, yeah, of course. Why not? You play green, blue? Oko. You play green or blue? Splash the other color for Oko. Why not? You need mana fixing? Astrolabe. Play snow lands. It's great times. Yep. I had an Oko at one of the pre-releases. I played in the finals of I think it was our last pre-release, and my opponent also had Oko. Game one, I cast Oko on turn like four, and I just won the game. Second game, my opponent cast it on turn three and won the game. Third game, I mulled to three. My hands had no lands in them. I mulled to three, and my hand was like land random spell, what is it called? It's a 3 mana 5/5 in standard right now that makes a 1/1. It's like a venture card. I don't actually know what it is. It's a beast thing. It's like the Beauty and the Beast card. Lovestruck Beast, yeah. So my hand was like Forest, Lovestruck Beast, random card. And I was like, "Okay, like I have to keep this." So I went land, Lovestruck Beast, drew a land, drew Oko, drew a land, played Oko, won the game. It was like, yeah, this is insane. Mulled to three, just play rare into mythic, can't stop it. My opponent was not happy. Not happy at all. Yeah, I'm pretty sure like pretty much anybody who had Oko that weekend would win the event. So yes, I hope that by the time Modern Horizons comes out, we'll be able to do some kind of event, some kind of pre-release. And then maybe once we open, then we can start going back and doing some like pre-releases for all these events that we missed. Get to do some like in-paper Aquaria and Zendikar. And I guess Kaldheim too. Kaldheim was really fun to play online. Oh, we're up. Right, Dustin. A nice green white deck for me tonight. This is fine. I don't want the tap land. They're just playing like the basic. Basic green white company deck. Think we should have a okay matchup against this. Ranger Captain can be pretty annoying here. Instead of a turn where we're not going to be able to stop him from comboing. Sure. You have a bunch of Oreo champions. Need to get some pretty sick value out of this if he actually gets to cast the Heliod. Was a decent draw. Not sure what he did with his Arbor Elf there. He's really gonna just like overwhelm us with creatures. Find something to deal with this Ranger Captain. I guess this turn we can Skyclave it if we wanted to. This is risky though. If he does have a Heliod, we'll be in a pretty bad position. Really use a sword right now. Bunch of life now. Right. No, we're one short. Skyclave. We want to take out. Take scavenging ooze. You only eat one thing right now, but conclave I think is actually like the issue. Like, I think this protects us more from Heliod. But he does end up with a pretty big scooze that we are gonna have to deal with at some point. He has Coco. Oh, yeah, he has Ballista. We did know we had Ballista, though. He has like a pad or something. I think we might be dead anyways. So it's possibly not gonna matter. Like, we need to actually draw a removal spell here. We can kill this. We can kill our Skyclave. We just dead if he kills anything. Kills that and he just attacks for three. We gotta kind of bluff having a removal spell then. Or now you can just pump it. We are dead anyways. Doesn't matter. Thank you. I don't think I'm a big fan of Aether Gust in this matchup. I think I'm okay with this. We like to play first. We like to mulligan. That's awkward. Well, I'm gonna get rid of here. If we get too far behind, that's pretty good. This could stop. This could get us back in the game. I think I like that. We don't draw lands, so I don't think we'll be able to get back in the game anyways, so. Oh. We are just dead. Yep. That's frustrating. See if we can get back into this. Does he have cocoa? That's fine. Not gonna be able to stop that anyways. Here. New Skyclave, get rid of this thing. Now they have to. They have to block this sword now. No, he's got a top deck something. You make this thing big, I don't really care. We can now either Shark Typhoon, Mana Leap, or Spell Queller, whatever it is that he ends up playing. Spell Queller this. Then we equip this sword to the Spell Queller instead. Actually, could have got the other sword as well there. But I think I'm going to chase this turn. We kind of lucked our way out of that one. That was pretty bad. Is there anything different that we want here? Run it back, see what we can do. We're not protected from combo with this hand. We could get a pretty quick sword though. Try it. Get feast and famine. He is stuck on lands. That is good for us. That is not what I wanted to do. Oh well. We've done it now. It'll be fine, but. Okay. Yeah, this actually works out fine. Could have been kind of awkward there. Let's get white. Let's activate. If he has path, then that would suck, but we are good. Please have Coco. Ooh, Walking Ballista. That's a problem. If I take out that thing, you can only do it for three. Then he can kill that. Then he only has one. It's 20 minutes, I think. I don't actually remember. That's annoying. much like have to draw Supreme Verdict here. I don't know if there's anything else I can do. We top decked it once last week. We can top deck it again today. That is not it. We stop enough of this. Bounce that. We get back our Theory Inspector. That doesn't do anything. We bounce that. We still only have one blocker. We have to draw. Have to draw removal. We're just dead. I played that game very poorly. Just forgot that the the issue is that like I'm gonna die to the ballista. It's like if I don't like I like planning for future turns, if I can't kill ballista that next turn, I'm dead no matter what. I think I had to draw a Supreme Verdict there. That was like my only out. Again, I just like not. I probably should not have gone for the sword play with the path. I think I could have played that turn a lot better. And then I just opened myself up to losing. Yeah, maybe. That might have been better. I'm gonna pull up the game. We're playing against Blue Moon today. Or sorry, Green Red Moon. Mainboard Elder Gargaroth. Spicy. I gotta stop clicking through my turns. What you got for me? Please don't dragon me. True. Oh, bolt into blood brain? That's pretty good. That's pretty spicy. Okay, he just has a blood moon's fine. Who needs colored mana when all you play is artifacts? Growth is pretty good. Play a Bonecrusher Giant too? Yeah. In here. If he doesn't top deck an answer to this Batterskull, we are gonna put a sword on this Batterskull, and we are gonna do some damage. Put Feast and Famine. Another Stone Forge for a blocker. To do anything here. Let me just pass a turn. All the weapons. Oh, and we drew the island. Ooh, baby. And a path? Ooh, what is this? This is a beautiful day. We're gonna bounce this blood moon. We're gonna equip this sword real quick. Payback for last week. It's payback for when he blood mooned me 2 games in a row. Aether Gust, Celestial Purge. What does he bring in? Got the glamour, cinder vines, collector oof. And it's got four main board pillage. So artifacts feel pretty bad against him. Possibly need to keep Force Negation, although I hate it. Might be okay with that. I think Spellcaller is not very good here. Skyclave is fine. Oh, what don't we want? We just have to keep the swords in because we want him to have to try and like pillage it. We play it right, we should be okay. Need Teferi. End up having so much removal. Maybe Mana Leak's not that great because he's ramping a little bit. Mana Leak's only good like early on. It's like maybe Mana Leak's only good on the play then. As I say that. Keep this, get rid of Synergy doesn't have any ramp. I usually like the green and moon decks that didn't have ramp were not very good. Oh, I guess if he's got Ren and Six, that's alright. Interesting. Definitely not allowing that. Bloodbraid or Chandra. I want Chandra. Ooh, Seasoned Pyromancer. Actually, do not want that. You could have Veil of Summer, which would be pretty bad. Alright. We can protect our Teferi and untap with it. We're pretty happy. We have two ways of balancing things. We stop Blood Braid. Dragon would be pretty bad for us. Is he playing it? He is. He's playing two Glorybringers. Chandra. Super awkward, he doesn't have any creatures yet. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5. Ulting Ren 6 doesn't even actually do anything right now. So it possibly like really hurt us later on in the game. Cindervine is pretty good. So we still need two more lands. Another one? We're gonna blow up our lands this turn? Yep. All right. Play the Arbor Elf? No, we didn't play the Arbor Elf. That was a mistake. We are going to exile this. don't even know what we want to draw here. Possibly just something that draws us more cards. It's fine. It's not great. This is an awkward spot now. Do you put pillage on top? Or I mean bloodbraid on bottom? Yes. Ooh. What is it? Seasoned Pyromancer. New. You can have the Bloodbraid, but you can't have the Seasoned Pyro. So pretty good draws. Just gonna die to that anyways. Clothis is too good there. Yeah, pounce the emblem. That'd be nice. Top decking two Bloodbraid is pretty good. Just have red in six. That'd be pretty annoying. with the blood move. The blood moon. Run in six on top. Still is nothing. What is? He's just got like a Gargaroth or something. I feel like I'm gonna get hit with something big. Why did I tap like that? I don't like that he has so many cards. Sure. There's double lightning bolt. Assuming that means he has Blood Braid. Sure. A Gargoth is gonna be a problem. Kind of annoying too. That's pretty good, I guess. Gargoth for the third time. Trancing Melody would have been pretty sweet there. To steal his Gargaroth. You need to draw something though. What if he's just sitting on pillages right now? He just has pillage and nothing to blow up. He doesn't want to do anything. I don't think we're gonna get much more of a chance to use that, so. Sword or something. Not another one. I don't want to lose my Teferi right now. Mirror's Call would be really good. That's a pretty good draw. He did have Illusummer too. Well, potentially a really good one. See what we can do with that. If we could draw a Mirror's Call right now, it'd be perfect. I don't know how many things he has to destroy a shark typhoon. I guess we'll find out though. Batter's Call would be a great draw. Sword is not bad either. I will take Sword. We will try to equip the sword. Alright, we have a shark with a sword. Does he have the pillage? We're getting there. Let's attack. I think you'll be dead next turn anyways. Let's kill something. Let's play this land, and we will pass a turn. We can still make a 1/1. There's the pillage.
did it. Yeah, right?
Man, we drew, like, real bad there. He must have drawn pretty bad, too. I did think he was probably sitting on Pillage for a while. Makes sense that he was sitting on Veil for a while, too. But yeah, like, we just drew a bunch of lands. The sharks, though. Casting a sword and getting a shark is great. And we had the Force Negation backup, which was actually clutch there. I was really hoping we'd get to draw Miria's Call, though. Make 2/4/4 angels and a 7/7 shark. He had Bloodbraid and Pyromancer. Yeah, but at least the Bloodbraid didn't do anything, though, because I had Teferi, right? So Bloodbraid, like, is just a 4-mana 3/2. Like, if he drew Chandra, or Glorybringer, or another Gargaroth, like, there's so many things he could have drawn that, like, I don't think I could have beaten. Like, I don't think I can beat Gargaroth at all. That card is insane. Like, I have to draw the removal spell. Even if he gets, like, one attack with it. My sharks can't get through it. It's got reach. Woohoohoo! Lurrus Jund deck? We are playing against Scarlet. Oh, this looks like... Oh, interesting. Why does this look like it's missing creatures? Scarlet, I don't know if I have you on here. Scarlet MTG... No. Oh, there you are. So we are playing as a Lurrus Jund deck that seems to be very low on creatures. There's just 4 Goyis, 2 Lurrus, and a Bloodbraid Elf. We will keep this. How many Inquisition and Thoughtseize? 4 Inquisition, 2 Thoughtseize. So playing 4 Lily and 4 Ren in 6. Likely lose our Mana Leak here, which means we can play Colonnade and then hold up 3 drops. Renin 6 is pretty good. Makes our clique much worse. We don't have the land for it, so. That's awkward. I don't want to spell color this. If I spell color it and they have removal. A seal of fire too. That's annoying. Planes. I'm gonna clique myself here. Not gonna be able to stop anything. Oh, I cannot beat myself. What am I doing? No. I don't know why I'm so click happy today. Apparently impatient. We can't have the J survive. We probably just lose this game anyways. So I just want to try and make sure my draw is good. So we're going to have to find an answer to this random 6-2. Yeah, they have blood braid. Well, they missed on the blood braid, so that's good. I'm going to have to draw 4 cards here. They have Bolt or something, that'd be pretty bad. Thought Caesar Inquisition would be great. Bait them a little bit into taking down the Renin 6. They might just try and keep drawing from it though. Fine. At least we shuffled away Field of Ruin there. He's tapped arrow now, which means we can colonnade this Renin 6. Wow, we drew Field of Ruin after that? That's annoying. Said that I'm here. He just texted me and said that he's here. Hmm. There's a pretty good draw there. Yep. Go ahead. What's up, dude?
Where do you want me to put this?
You can just put it down there. That's fine.
Sweet. Oh, I appreciate it, man.
Yeah, no problem.
Have fun. I like
Yeah.
your shark with a
Oh,
shark
you
with a
watching
sword.
that?
Yeah, I'm betting.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
I'm getting messed up right now. Let's see if this could actually like bring me back in. But
All right, have fun.
thanks. Yeah, see ya. That was a decent draw. I don't know if it's gonna be enough though. Maybe. You're gonna need to have some kind of removal. Trying six fresh cards could be pretty good. That might be a real problem. Yep. All right. It's a nice little wheel for yourself. She has to have removal though. She doesn't have removal. She's dead to my flyers. Oh, two seal of fires, all right. That kills one of them. Yep. Yep. That's pretty good. Yep. What are the chances they have push? Guess I could blow up this. And then they can't have push. Thank you. We're still not in a great spot. I have 7 cards, dude. And they have a redraw in their JMP lands. Like, I need them to have, like, nothing. I need to draw, like, a sword. Yeah, they do have Fatal Push. That makes sense. They fetch, Fatal Push, a Skyclave. Interesting. What do you do? 5. 1, 2, that's not enough. Need Lily to die here. Yep. We are getting very flooded. Even sword doesn't really help us here. We need to, like, get Battle Skull instead so we can protect from Lily. We need to do, like, back-to-back Stoneforge. Teferi would be okay. Because then we can kill the Lily. This guy is kind of average. I guess we can kill the Lily. Yeah, that's pretty good. Alright, we killed the Lily. Interesting. I don't know what she's saying. I'm apparently supposed to be at 13 or 11 right now. Oh. Alright. Teferi is a decent draw here. Bounce this. Ooh, Stoneforge is a good draw. Okay, we need to deal with this. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make sure that can't alt. Ooh, traverse. What do you get at traverse? Thanks, Chris. I couldn't remember. Alright, you got a Goyf. An 8-9 Goyf. Oh no, yeah, the Inquisition. Why? Why? Oh man. Maybe I should have just been attacking her the whole time. Maybe I would have been dead by now. That's very late. Oh, spicy. Just a third red. It's like, sure, you got it. Man, I drew so bad. What do you want to get rid of here? Here's Spellqueller. Here's some force negations. Get rid of fire and ice. Get rid of ousts. Not actually that many creatures. Get rid of force negation. I were fine with that. Valakut's Awakening actually did work. Just draw six more cards. Can keep this. That's pretty good. Oil. Nice. Oh, we'll get rid of the lily. Ooh. I like that. That's spicy. This is so spicy. All you have is boil. That's very good. I think I'm still okay with that. To kind of take the mana leak. The colors are not great though. You'd have to draw lands. Because we only need one land, and then we can set up the rest. It's a good sign for us. Try set up K command or something, I guess. Doesn't really give us any reason to cast anything. Yeah, game two took a while. Interesting. You blow up their land in response, and then I'll have two lands untapped. All right, 1, 2, 3. Let's go get a forest anyways. Double red doesn't matter. Maybe it does. I don't know if they're still on the like land destruction plan. Don't pass through your turn. Yep. Starfire, sure. That's pretty good. Play a Goyf so I can steal it. Oh yeah, that's good too. Sure. Super annoying. Yeah, that's fine. Is it May, right? No, it's not, you don't control anyways. Yeah, that's fine. Just want to get a creature out there, put some pressure. I have one card left in their hand anyways. That was a mistake. Come on. Ooh, Cleek is good. I guess I don't really want to do it in our upkeep though. Not too worried about what they draw here. I'd rather get the Cleek end of turn, because if it's removal they won't be able to use it. Oh, I probably could have kept the red and six. No, I guess that's fine because we're gonna kill this one. Alright, one, two, one, two, three, we can't do both. Marine cast this, go get a Batter Skull. I feel like I definitely could have played that a little bit better, but I think we're good anyways. I don't think it matters. Yeah. Like, we can do so many things against this right now. But we're just gonna steal the Goyf. Yeah. Finally got to cast the entrancing melody. Card's pretty sweet. Where's this thing? So, here's the deck that I played. It was fun, again. Feels really strong. I played very bad against Dustin. I definitely think I could have done better there. I like the Therabian Inspectors. I definitely got to draw a bunch of cards off of it. It was good as a blocker, good as something just to equip a sword to, just making sure you had the creatures. So I do like the include of that. I don't know, you crushed me game one. That wasn't even really close. But yeah, I like it a lot. It's definitely a fun deck to play. I don't know if I really want to change anything for the sideboard. It seems pretty stock. Supreme Verdict was really good today. Celestial Purge and Gust were pretty good today. Astriarch was okay. We didn't bring in D-Stroke. And we brought in Transient Melody in once. So, yeah. Yeah, it's just three rounds. I got to cast the Myria's Call twice. I got to cast Shark Typhoon once. I got to equip one shark, Flying Tornado Shark, with a sword. We just got to do all the fun things today. So yeah, I like it. I'm gonna keep playing it. I'm gonna try and maybe run some leagues this week. See if there's anything else that I want to change, but I think it's a pretty solid choice. And if you play better than I do, then you'll probably do really well. Because I've been 3-2-ing and 2-1-ing. And I play horribly. Where's this thing? Yeah, thanks for coming out, guys. It was fun. Hopefully we can get some more people out next week. And if you are cracking any Time Spiral Remastered, good luck. Get me a foil Thoughtseize, please. Or foil Blood Braids or Brotekaze. All those things will do. Thanks. See you guys later.